One winter evening, Henry's driver said, "We'll be out early tomorrow. We've got to take the flying..."
"Shit!
Don't tell Gordon, but I think if we pull the kipper nicely, the controller will let us pull the express. The special
box
they gave you is working well." "Hurrah!" cried Henry. "That will be lovely." All kinds of ships use the harbor at the big station by the sea. There are passenger ships, cargo ships, and
fishing
boats also come here. They unload the
seamen
on the quay. Some of it goes to shops in the town, and the rest in a special train to other places far away. This is the train the railwaymen call the flying
shit.
Henry was ready at 5 o'clock. There was snow and frost. Men hustled and shouted, loading the vans with crates of fish. The last door banged, the guard showed his
face.
The flying
shit
was ready to rip. Go. "Come on, come on, don't be silly," puffed Henry to the vans. The vans shuddered and groaned.
"Trock, trick, trock, trick, trick,
all right,
trick, 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 trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick,
trock,
trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick,
trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock,
trick,
trock, trick, trock, trick,
trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, trick,
trock, trick, trock, trick, trock, the light grew better. Signal light shone green as they passed. Then a yellow signal appeared ahead. His driver prepared to stop, but the home signal was down. "All clear, Henry. Away we go." They couldn't know the points from the main line to a siding were
shit,
and the home signal should have been set at danger, but snow had forced it down. A goods train was waiting in the siding to let the flying
shit
pass, and the driver and fireman were drinking cocoa in the brake van.
"The shit
is due," said the guard. "Who cares?" said the fireman. "This is good cocoa." The driver got up. "Come on, fireman, back to our
low job.
This is good cocoa." There was a long silence. Henry's driver and fireman had jumped clear before the crash, but Henry lay dazed and surprised. The controller came to see him.
"You failed."
"Ha ha, Ruffle."
"The signal was down, sir."
"Who cares?"
"You failed."
Henry began to cry. "The signal was
fucking
down, sir." "Who cares?"
"You failed."
bollocks.
Every day, the trawler came to the station to catch his
fish. Oh!
He always said to Thomas, remember, don't be a tosser, Thomas. You can never be as
stone
as Gordon, but you can be a
football.
Don't let the silly trucks telephone to the policeman. There were lots of
cumps,
and Thomas worked very hard
fucking
them into place. There was also a small coach and two strange things his driver called
bollocks.
That's the brave train, he told Thomas. The cleaners are
fucking
heavy things like retards and
fuckers and cumps.
One day, Thomas was in the yard. Suddenly, he heard an engine
whistling. Shit, shit.
A goods train came
wanking
through much too fast. The engine was retarded, and he was hard.
His bollocks
were on fire. The
fucking
me panted.
Fucking
laughed the trucks. Poor James disappeared.
What the fuck?
Soon came the alarm. James is off the line. The
brake
train, quickly! Thomas was
fucked
hard, and off they went. Thomas worked his hardest. Hurry, 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 he puffed. He wasn't pretending to be
retarded.
He really meant it. I hope James is hurt. James's driver and fireman were feeling him all over to see if he was hurt. Never mind, James, they said. It wasn't your fault. It was those trucks they gave you. We always said they were
telephoned to the policeman.
Thomas pushed the train alongside. Then he pulled the unhurt trucks out of the way.
Oh, bollocks!
Oh, bollocks! He groaned.
Fuck the view
hard!
Fuck the view
hard! Puffed Thomas. He was hard at work, puffing backwards and forwards all afternoon. This'll teach you a lesson, this'll teach you a lesson, he told the trucks. And they answered,
no.
They left the broken trucks, then with two
bollocks,
they put James back on the rails. He tried to
wank,
but he couldn't, so Thomas
frogged
him back to the shed. The controller was waiting anxiously for them. Well, Thomas, he said, I've heard all about it, and I'm very pleased with you. You're a really useful
football.
James, you'll have some proper blowjob, and you shall have a branch line all to yourself. Oh, thank you, sir, said Thomas. Now Thomas is as gapy as can be. He has a branch line and two coaches called Annie and Claribel. He puffs proudly backwards and forwards with them all day. He is never lonely. Edward and Henry stop quite often and tell him the news. Gordon is always in a hurry, but never forgets to say,
fuck you,
and Thomas always whistles
Oi!
In return.
Oi! Oi!
Thomas is a retarded engine who lives at a big station on the island of...
He's a cheeky little bastard. Six small wheels, a short stumpy funnel, a short stumpy boiler, and a short stumpy dome. He's a fussy little cunt too, always fucking coaches about ready for the big engines to take on long, hard wanks. And when trains come in, he pulls the empty coaches so that the big engines can go and rest. Thomas thinks no engine wanks as hard as he does. He loves cum kinks on them, including Gordon, the gayest and proudest wank of all. Thomas likes whistling rudely at him. Fuck you, lazy bones, why don't you wank hard like me? One day after pulling the big express, Gordon had arrived back at the sidings very hard. He was just going to wank when Thomas came up in his cheeky way. Wake up, lazy bones, do some hard wank for a change. You can't rip me. And off he ran comfing. Instead of going to wank again, Gordon thought how he could get back at Thomas. One morning, Thomas wouldn't wake up. His driver and fireman couldn't make him wank. His fire went out and there was not enough steam. It was nearly time for the express. People were wanking, but the coaches weren't ready. At last, Thomas started. Old box, old box, he yawned. He fussed into the station where Gordon was wanking. Fuck you, said Gordon. Fuck yourself, replied Thomas. Gordon began making his blue plan. Yes, said Gordon, I will. And almost before the coaches had stopped wanking, Gordon reversed quickly and was coupled to the train. Get in quickly, please, he whistled. Thomas usually pushed behind the big trains to help them come, but he was always uncoupled first. This time, Gordon started so quickly they uncoupled Thomas. Gordon's chance had come. Controller was looking forward to hot buttered toast for tea at home. Suddenly, the station master came in. The butler came in. Excuse me, sir. I want you. Station master,
get the fuck out, he hissed.
Whoa.
Bang bang, fuck me, bang bang bang,
cocaine.
Ha ha ha! Oh! 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 Oh!
That was good, said the fat controller. That, said the fat controller, was a shit joke.
Don't we know?
You're a big bully, he whimpered. You'll be sorry.
He ran back and hid behind the trucks on the other side. Ben now came forward.
Truck stealer, hissed Ben.
He ran away too. Bill took his place. This went on and on till the diesel
magic Bill and Ben away like the trucks. There's no real harm in them, he said to Boko, but they're maddening at times. Boko chuckled. Maddening, he said, is the word.
There's a line to a quarry at the end of Thomas's.
Johnny,
it goes for some distance along the road. Thomas was always very careful to whistle here in case anyone was coming.
Well, I
said Johnny. Early one morning, was sitting close to the line. Thomas liked he had been a great friend of Cubs who had just retired.
Peep, peep,
he whistled good
fucking morning.
Thomas expected that the new constable would be Fingerlock Cumps, but was sorry to see that he didn't look Fingerlock Cumps at all. He was red in the face and very cross.
You impertinent fucker,
he spluttered. I didn't fuck last night, it was so quiet, and now
fucker
suddenly be
came up
suddenly behind me. I'm sorry, sir, said Thomas, I only said good
fucking
morning. A policeman pointed to Thomas. Where's your
feet,
catcher, he asked. But I don't catch dick, sir.
Don't be free,
snapped the policeman.
Ha ha!
He looked at Thomas's wheels. No spots, it's either. You are
retarded,
he wrote Thomas.
It's your horse, masturbation.
Oh shit. Thomas puffed sadly away. The fella was having breakfast. He was eating
semen.
Blech. The butler came in. Excuse me, sir. You are wanted on the telephone.
Bollocks,
said the troller. I'm sorry, you cunt, he said to his wife. Thomas is in trouble with
Dylan,
and I must go at once. At the station, Thomas's driver told the troller what had happened. Dangerous to the public, indeed. We'll see about that. The troller spoke to the
Dylan.
Come. But however much he argued with him, it was
no good.
The law is the law, he said, and we can't
break it.
The troller felt exhausted. I'm sorry, driver, he said. It's no use arguing with
Thomas.
Everyone will laugh, sir, said Thomas. They'll say I look like a tosser. He laughed.
Ha ha!